Hi, NPC Seahawks. This is Jocelyn Ireland bringing you a video about the importance of doing headings in Microsoft Word for your syllabus. Headings are really important to use for your syllabus because it provides an easy way for students to skim the contents of your syllabus, and it also provides students that are using screen readers or other assistive technology to be able to read your syllabus in an effective manner. So I have an example syllabus that does not have headings. So some common places to put headings would be the title or your course name, and of course the major sections of your syllabus. So headings are super easy to use. You're just going to highlight the text that you want to make a heading. And the heading styles are up here on the top of Microsoft Word. Now, as you can see, as I'm hovering over these headings, it's changing the style of my font style. And let's say I don't want to change the style. I already have it the way I want it. So the name of your syllabus should be Heading 1. So I'm just going to hover over Heading 1. And I don't want to change my font style though. So I'm just going to right click on Heading 1 and say Update to Match Selection. So now when I click on the text that I had selected, it says it is now Heading 1 style. And it didn't change my font style at all because I did that right click and matched it to my current selection. Now I'm going to go to my next heading, which is Professor. And I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to highlight where I want my heading. And since this isn't the title of my document, I'm going to put it as a Heading 2. And the Heading 2 style is not that different from what I already have selected, but I'm going to do the same thing and just update Heading 2 to match selection. And it did change the spacing a little bit, but that's okay. I can work with that. And I'll do the next thing for my course description. Just highlight it, Heading 2, and there we have it. And since it was the same heading style, and I already said matched it to the previous selection, so that time I didn't have to right click and match it to the current selection. It remembered the font style that I liked. So now it's super quick. Highlight the text and select Heading 2. Now you might find reason where you want to make like a subheading a heading style as well. So to do that, you can just highlight it. And just like before, I can just right click on it and update Heading 3 to match the current style. So then it'll be really easy to do the same for all of these. So besides, you know, making it easier for students with disabilities or providing a nice visual outline for your document, and also if you transition your Word document to a PDF, it'll save those heading styles, so it'll continue to be accessible for users in the PDF form. You can also create either a table of contents or internal hyperlinks really easily when you create heading styles. So I'll just give an example of that real quick. Let me just do a little page break here. Let's say I want to do a little table of contents on this page here. To do a table of contents after you've done heading styles, you go to the References tab, and there'll be a table of contents button, and it'll give you different options to choose. I'll just choose Automatic Table 2. And here's my table of contents. And I see some of these are a little wonky, but I can delete that. And you can always change, you know, the style of any of this. Let's say I don't want bullet points there. I can take those bullet points off. So anything that you have listed as a heading will appear automatically in your table of contents. And if there's anything you don't want in your table of contents, but you had as a heading, you can always just highlight it and delete it off. When you share this document, this table of contents will be hyperlinked to those sections. So that's super helpful. And when you use heading styles, you can also hyperlink, do internal hyperlinks. So let's say you're talking about like some major assignments and you have another section that provides an outline of those due dates for that, those assignments. You can highlight the text, go to insert, go to hyperlink, and you can do place in this document, and anything you have as a heading will appear as an option that you can hyperlink to. So I hope that gives you a good idea of how to create headings in Microsoft Word for your syllabus and how to create a table of contents and internal hyperlinks. If you have any questions at all, don't hesitate to contact me. My email is jireland@mvcc.edu. Have a good day.